It's always stressful when you apply for a new job and you're given a take-home project to complete. The stakes are high because you want to get that job, but for that, you need this take-home project to be successful. So in order to help you at this challenging time, I've made a list of 5 tips that should help you pass this test. Let's start with tip number 1. Tip number 1 is to make sure that you identify and follow all the requirements of the assignment. So make sure that you carefully read and understand all the requirements that are mentioned in the briefing of the assignment. And by requirements, I mean things like the minimum version of iOS that must be supported, a specific pattern to implement, like MVVM, for instance, or the coordinator pattern, a library that you are supposed to use or not use, for instance, UIKit or SwiftUI, or using AlamoFire, or instead not using AlamoFire and implementing everything through the native URL session, this kind of thing, but also the expected design of the UI. And the reason why you want to make sure that you pay attention to these requirements is because they are basically the criteria that will be used to grade your project. So making sure that you get them right is really important if you want to succeed the test. Here's how I would recommend that you proceed. Before you start working on the project, carefully read the assignment and make a list of all the requirements. If you're not 100% familiar with some of the requirements, for instance, if a pattern is asked and you've never implemented it before, take the time to do a bit of research so that you get yourself up to speed. And when you've finished working on the project, take the time to go over that list once more to make sure that you've indeed ticked all of the boxes and that you haven't forgotten something by mistake. Now let's move on to tip number 2, make a good first impression. You want your project to convey a strong feeling of quality and care at the very first glance. And there are several ways that you can ensure this impression. First, you can make sure that your Xcode project is nicely organized. So you want to split your source files logically across several folders, like one folder for the views, one folder for the model, one for the services, etc. What you don't want is to have 2 dozens of source files just laid out without any kind of sorting or logical order at the root of your project, because it won't give a good impression when the reviewer opens your project for the first time. And on the same line of thinking, you also want to make sure that your app runs correctly in dark mode. The reason is that dark mode is pretty popular with developers, and so there's a good chance that the reviewer will have their phone or their simulator set up in dark mode. And if when they launch your app in dark mode, the UI looks broken, it's not a great first impression. And most of the time, when there is an issue in dark mode, it's quite easy to fix. It's often a color that is incorrectly set, so it's really worth it to spend the few extra minutes to make sure that your app works correctly in dark mode. And it's always a good idea to spend a few minutes to write a short README file that you will leave at the root of the project and that will contain any useful information to help the reviewer understand how your project works. And on a similar topic, tip number 3 is to explain your design choices. Remember that a take-home project is nothing more than a proxy to evaluate your skills. So anything that helps demonstrate your expertise is always worth mentioning. There is no need to write a dissertation. Just a couple of sentences are enough to explain things like the APIs that you chose to call. For instance, why did you choose to use async await versus using combine? Or the third-party libraries that you decided to use or not to use. For instance, if you chose to use URL session over AlamoFire to implement the network calls, or even any interesting choice that you made when modeling the structure of your app, for instance, choosing to use an actor instead of a class, or using an enum with associated values. Now let's move on to tip number 4, which is don't add something that's not relevant. It's never a good idea to introduce unnecessary complexity to your project just for the sake of showing that you are aware of something's existence. By that, I mean don't call APIs that are not relevant to the assignment, or don't offer 2 different implementations of the same thing unless it's being explicitly asked in the requirements. If you want to mention that you know the existence of something that's not 100% relevant, it's totally fine, but it's much better to just mention it in a comment or in your README. But you don't want to implement something that's not relevant because it will give a very amateurish feeling to your project. And finally, tip number 5 is to take the time to discuss the next steps to improve your project. You might not have the time to implement everything that you know, and it's totally okay, but you can still write a few bullet points in your README about how to improve the project further. This can include how you can improve the architecture, for instance, by introducing dependency injection or by following a popular pattern like TCA, the composable architecture, or with having a better testing strategy, or with a better support of the Apple ecosystem, and by that I mean supporting devices like the iPad, the Mac, or why not, even the Vision Pro. The goal of doing so is that it shows that you took the time to take a step back and think critically about your work, but it's also a great way to offer some talking points that can be discussed during the assignment review. So that's it, these were my 5 tips for a successful iOS take-home project. If you have an upcoming iOS take-home project, I hope they'll be able to help you succeed. As always, if you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss the next video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.